God of mercy, you are the hope of sinners and the joy of saints. We pray for Brother Jerry, whose body we honor with Christian burial. Give him happiness with your saints, and raise up his body in glory on the last day to be in your presence forever. Grant this through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A time to be born and a time to die, a time to kill and a time to heal, a time to tear down and a time to build, a time to laugh and a time to cry, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to embrace and a time to be alone, a time to seek and a time to let go, a time to be silent and a time to speak, a time to hate and a time to love, a time for conflict and a time for peace. All that we do is right before its time. We question, but we cannot understand the work of the God, the work of God from beginning to end.
And also with you.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again and take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
To you, Dolores, and to all of the relatives and friends, we will be mentioning Jerry's name at all the masses this weekend so that the parish will be praying for him and also for all of you. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. Have faith in Jesus Christ. These words that Jesus is speaking in the Gospel are the words in John's Gospel at the Last Supper. These are the words to prepare his disciples for the events that would occur later that evening and on Good Friday, Holy Saturday, and the resurrection on Easter morn. So to give his disciples comfort, the first thing he tells them is, do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, the Father. Have faith also in me, and that is Jesus Christ. And when I hear these words, I cannot help but think that Jerry also wants to tell us the same thing. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God. And have faith in Jesus Christ. Because Jerry believed in God. Believed in what had been spoken to him in the scriptures. Believed in what he lived, how he lived out his life. He was a Eucharistic minister and had done much things here at St. Columbia. But the readings kind of give us a hint as to how Jerry was able to have faith in God and have faith in Jesus Christ. And I believe they can be summed up in the words spoken at his wedding. In good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, till death do us part. The living out of the vows were seen sorrow, time for sorrow, that life is going to be filled with the good and the bad, sickness and health. And yet we are to remain faithful. So that no matter what comes in our life, we're being reminded that we remain faithful. And Jerry, in the last few years, was in poor health. And yet Jerry and Dolores showed to their friends and relatives and the parish how important it is to live out those vows of marriage. Because the second reading on love is the type of love that Jerry and Dolores have shown to us. Because in the struggles of life and in the joys of life, they persevered. The love that they had for one another was a giving love, a love of dying to self, a love that is modeled after Jesus Christ. His love, giving of himself in death, brought to us eternal life. The love that Jerry had for Dolores and Dolores for Jerry was a giving love, a love of giving himself, and in so doing, they were able to show to the rest of us how it is to be a follower of Christ.